Good morning, everyone. We are continuing here in the Kitzur Shulchan Aruch and the laws of hiring, lending, or leasing to a non-Jew on Shabbos or before Shabbos. And the halach is today like this. Uman Akum, if you have a non-Jew who is a craftsman, he's an expert in his field of craft. She'asa mabush b'shvil Yisrael, he made a garment. He's a tailor, he made a garment for a Jew. V'hevi'o lo b'Shabbos, and then he brings it to the Jew's house on Shabbos. Mutar lalavshay, the Jew is allowed to wear this garment. Ve'im yedua shegmaro b'Shabbos. However, if you know that this guy finished making this garment for the Jew, and he finished making it on Shabbos, ein lalavshay, then you should not wear it. Ki'im l'tzarech gadol, unless it's great need and necessity, and there's many details over there of exactly how you could put it on, how long you have to wait, so on and so forth, in such a case. And these are much more unlikely situations to happen in our generations. It used to be that anything you wanted to wear, you had to have made for you. Today we go to the department stores, you shop on Amazon.com, the food, the clothing comes already made, and therefore it's a little bit different the way we're going to deal with things. However, you're not allowed to take vessels, utensils, and clothing from the house of this non-Jewish craftsman. Afilu mi'uman Yisrael, even from a Jewish craftsman, you can't. But Shabbos for Yom Tov, you cannot take it on Shabbos and Yom Tov. Because, what's the issue over here? It looks like everything was finished and completed for the Jew on Shabbos or on Yom Tov. And that you nobody's allowed to work for you. The Akum Sheinu Uman, if you have a non-Jew, who's not a craftsman, Elishiyesh no Chanut, but he has a store. He's a store owner. He doesn't make things himself. He just buys them and he puts them in his store. Shemaychem in the Olam Kedami, he has a shoe store. He sells shoes, other types of items. Mutal Yisrael HaMakiroi. If a Jew is familiar with him and is trusted by this non-Jew, Likach Menu B'Shabbos, he can actually take the shoes from this store on Shabbos without paying for them, or the Na'alam, and wear them, and he'll pay after Shabbos. Now he brings down in the notes over here that the Mishnah Berurah is not excited about this halacha. And if a person would be in such a situation, he really would have to ask a competent halachic authority if he's allowed to do something like that. As long as they don't fix the price on Shabbos, because you cannot discuss business dealings on Shabbos. So too, obviously you can't bring things that are outside the Tichum. We'll speak later on regarding the Tichum, how far it is things are allowed to be outside of your area of space, and if they come from too far, which is approximately 2,000 amos, which is quite some distance, then you would not be allowed to wear them anyway. Okay, let's see another halacha over here. Kelim sha'isim malacha, if you have items that are used for malacha, for work, kagoy machresha, kiyotziva, you have a plow, similar utensils. Asa la'askel la'akum b'erev Shabbos, you cannot rent this out to a non-Jew on Erev Shabbos. Even though we're not commanded al shvisas kelim to keep our utensils at rest on Shabbos the way that we have to be, since that the Jew is taking payment for the rental, v'hiskir b'erev Shabbos, and he rented it out on Erev Shabbos, looks like the non-Jew is a shliach, is an agent, a messenger of the Jew, and he's really working on behalf of the Jew. That's what it looks like. However, on Thursday, already you'd be allowed to do that, because then you would not have to be concerned that he looks like a shliach, that he looks like a messenger for you. Okay, those are the halachas today. We have, Bez Hashem, one more halacha to do tomorrow. And we'll close off the chapter on Erev Shabbos. All the best.